this last week on Martin Luther King Day, you announced your plan for providing reparations to the descendants of slaves. In the New York Times editorial board meeting on December 12th, here's what you told them. Mm-hmm. You said, look, reparations don't mean a thing without reconciliation, in my view. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of unfinished business in this country, and I don't think it's going to get resolved by just writing a check. So are you for cash payments, cash reparation payments?
The answer is maybe. And it has a lot to do, Margaret, with the fact that there's a lot of our history. When I say our history, I don't mean just black people, American history, that a lot of Americans don't understand. There are reasons why the wealth gap, for example, is what it is. It's been stuck where it has been for a long, long time. It isn't surmountable. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was for me. Mm-hmm. You know, the story of my story of growing up in poverty and being able to have the kinds of opportunities I've had and the and to make a little money. That's a story. That's a deeply American story. It's a story that gets told more here than any place else in the world. But as a group, there are reasons why this has been a heavier and harder lift for Black Americans. And I think it's important that America understand that. The reason I said I hedged on the check is because I think we have some homework to do first. And I say this in part as someone who's represented folks in court who got paid and then didn't feel resolution once they got paid. And you'll see if you put the reparations question in our policy alongside the other elements, that there's a lot we're talking about in terms of reinvesting in housing and in infrastructure and job training and business creation.